So one face we are not used to seeing here is Yeti.
Yeah, and Yeti, you know, a lot of people saw him last weekend. He's a great Mega Man player from the Midwest, and this guy has just been known for his Mega Man since day, like, negative 14 of this game.
Yeah, he's putting in some work, and I've seen him do some great stuff again tonight, so I'm excited to see what he's bringing to the table in this match.
Yeah, and his opponent, DBA, I'm not really quite sure where he's from.
Yeah, but
Jojo the Hobo. There we go. I'm saying that 5 times fast.
I want to say someone said he was like from the Washington area. I'm not sure,
but okay.
I think that could have just been something else. But regardless, these are two people we're not used to seeing here, and they're both in winner's quarters here at Xanadu.
Yeah, so if you're all the way from PNW, you know, you're going to want to win some money to make that flight home back, because it's a long flight.
Yeah, it's a long flight home, so hopefully these guys get their well rest after, of course, beating the hell out of each other.
Yeah. I mean, you got to earn your rest first. I mean, it looks like right now Jojo the Hobo is ready to go to sleep, and he's sleeping.
Yeah, not quite the spike that we wanted to see, but still, Yeti manages to snuff out Jojo the Hobo with a nice dare.
Yeah. And yeah, you were right. I looked it up. He is from Washington, so all the way from PNW. Shout out to those guys over there.
Yeah, coast to coast. That's a long flight for sure, so hopefully he tuckers himself out playing Smash, because Yeti's a beast.
Oh, yeah, yeah. If you're not tired yet, Yeti will wear you down, because that's kind of like his play style. He is a bit more aggressive than a lot of other Mega Man, but even still, you know, Mega Man just has that inherent keep away to his character that wears a lot of people down. Sometimes he just wins by attrition, in a way.
Yeah, no, Mega Man is definitely, like you said, a war of attrition. Those pellets, the Metal Blade, the Crash Bomber, it wears you down bit by bit until you are in kill percentage before you know it.
Mm-hmm.
And Yeti's going to be there waiting.
Oh, yeah. I mean, even now, some would argue that Toon Link, I've been mixing it up since day one, but Toon Link is in kill percentage just because Mega Man's kill power is very high as well. If he gets an up tilt about now, I mean, he's going to just explode. And if he gets a forward smash also, he might not die. Well, now he'll die, but it'll be still bad news.
Yeah, and we saw there a second ago that Toon Link Shield actually managed to block a pellet, but that's still not going to be enough to save you from Yeti. You're going to need a lot more than just a nice shield to save yourself. It's just like we saw there with that back air, snuffing out Jojo Hobo's second stock.
Yeah, right now Yeti's just trying to make this a solid three stock as he sets up with his Metal Blade, puts a Crash Bomber on him, which kind of stops that aggression that Jojo the Hobo was ready to have. He had the up tilt, he had a juggle scenario, but because the Crash Bomber was on him, he had to keep his feet grounded in shield. And look at how that sets up.
Oh, my God.
Because Yeti nicks him. No, he has a jump. He says an up B, but Yeti tried to finish it all.
Yeah, he tried to go for something snazzy there. Not quite finding it, but still snazzy.
Yeah, and he almost gets a forward smash, too. But we're in the endgame scenario, so this is the point where, I mean, it's still... It's not impossible, but it's definitely not probable.
Oh!
And now it's impossible.
Goodbye. That's a solid three stock from Yeti, yielding to 184.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez, I knew Mega Man was heavy, but come on.
Yeah, and I mean, a lot of Young Link... I did it again. A lot of Toon Link players have been kind of lamenting the character's loss of confirms from Smash 4 to Ultimate, because before in Smash 4, he used to be able to just throw a bomb and then up air, back air, forward air, down air in some scenarios, or boomerang, close range boomerang into all those options as well. But now it's a bit more situational, so this character has some trouble killing if he doesn't get a hard read.
Yeah, and I like the Kalos pick because it gives more space to Hobo. Of course, that's also going to play into Mega Man, because these guys are both zoners. These guys both have projectiles up the wazoo, but I think maybe that will come into play and maybe help out JoJo.
Yeah, but, I mean, Mega Man's an interesting kind of zoner, because he's a zoner from, like, the mid-range. Like, far range, I feel like Toon Link has the advantage, but from the mid-range onward, it's just all Yeti, which is why Yeti's been kind of giving him the hands early on.
Yeah, no, yeah, you can see that right now that Yeti, that JoJo, rather, wants to take a step back and manage to throw some projectiles, but Yeti's staying within a certain kind of range, you know, not always right up next to you, but really close enough so that his pellets are going to work.
Oh, my God.
And then that Buster Shot is going to work.
It did more than work. I mean, I feel like Jojo the Hobo did a little bit of some sus DI there. But, yeah, you had a good point there. The line of scrimmage for Yeti is just pretty much the max range of his pellets. That's where he wants to be.
That is the best spot for Mega Man to be in, because it definitely trips up players. Trips up B whenever. Because, you know, those have just enough stun on them to make you stop you what you're doing.
Mm.
Keeps him in your tracks. And that's what Yeti's game plan is here. You can see he's dancing very close, bobbing in and out of Jojo's range. You know, not quite near enough to get slapped by the sword, but enough that he can just get smacked by projectiles all day long.
Yeah, and I mean, JoJo, he hasn't been able to get any bomb confirms just because every time he's in range for a bomb, he's also kind of in range for the pellets or to get kind of counter hit by the Metal Blade as well.
Yeah, and you saw him getting a slap of the air cutter there. Yeti managed trying to find something like Slash Claw to secure that stock.
Ooh.
But JoJo, you know, finally getting a kill going in for him. could work. But still, already at triple digit percent for himself. Not great. Yep, ledge trump to back air. Goodbye. That slash claw hurts.
Yeah, and especially if you don't react or DI in time. It looks like JoJo's kind of caught sleeping, but I don't blame him because there's so many other things to think about in the Mega Man matchup. All these little moving parts, like with the pellets, the metal blades, the flame sword, the back air, the leaf shield also, it's easy to forget about the game mechanics that you have to fight on top of that.
Yeah, you know, as you said, you know, there are a bunch of working parts. These, you know, all these projectiles, you know, the flame, and even the flame sword, the slash claw, these are all cogs in the machine that is Mega Man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Dr. Wily really knows how to build them. Or not Dr. Wily.
Dr. Light. Yeah. Mega Man's cool. He's our hero.
Yeah, yeah.
Dr. Light is right when he made Mega Man because he's so good.
Mm-hmm.
He survived the test of time.
Well, we won't talk about, like, you know, some of the... I mean... Oh, wait, I was thinking my number nine. Okay, yeah.
We don't talk about my number nine. Mega Man, cool. Yeah, you're good.
Mega Man's cool.
Mega Man's pretty dope. 11 came out. Pretty all right.
Yeah. I heard, like... 8 and 9 were pretty good, too.
Oh, I love 9. 9, 9 and 10, when they came out for like the Wii, the WiiWare, that was so good.
Yeah.
Oh, not connecting that Metal Blade to Up Tilt combo, but still, this is not the position that JoJo wants to be in, a full stock behind.
Yeah, especially since... Oh my god, he tried to
hit
it all
so
right there.
That was so close.
But yeah, I was about to say, especially in the last game, Mietti was on his like last stock, or first stock at 150, and I mean, JoJo just couldn't kill him. So if you're already this far behind, it doesn't bode well for your chances for the rest of the set.
It is a mountain to climb for sure, but it's possible. You never know.
Yeah.
Yeti's doing everything he can to make it more. Oh, excellent work by Yeti. Just keeping JoJo, you know, trapped at ledge, not getting that, you know, big buster shot he wanted. But still, he's just going from ledge to ledge, back and forth, just trying to get some safety. But it's not working until finally he manages to get a nice fair and take off Yeti's second stock.
Okay, so now JoJo has to go absolutely wild and crazy and stupid.
This is difficult to say the least. You are 155. Good luck, man.
Yeah. If you get one hit, you kind of have to press your advantage and keep on going. And that could be the start of it. There you go. Nice up throw up air. Putting on a quick 40.
That's some percentage on the board. He has to be so careful. Just so many things can kill at this percentage. You got to just play it easy. Don't stress yourself out, but Flame Sword catches you.
Yeah, and it looked like he was trying to run away and holding straight to the right because he...